Good morning, friends, and welcome to the Leeward Islands District devotional for today. I am Sister Myrna George, a local preacher on trial in the St. Thomas St. John Circuit, sharing in today's theme, In Mission to the Family. Let us pray. We thank you, Lord, that you have afforded us yet another opportunity to praise your name and meditate on your word. May my words be acceptable in your presence. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. This meditation is taken from Deuteronomy chapter 6, verses 4 through 9. Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. You shall love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your might. Keep these words that I am commanding you today in your heart. Recite them to your children and talk about them when you are at home and when you are away, when you lie down and when you rise. Bind them as a sign on your hand. Fix them as an emblem on your forehead and write them on the doorposts of your house and on your gates. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Holistically, this passage of scripture sets a pattern which helps us relate the word of God to our daily lives. To truly understand and apply this passage of scripture to our lives, we must remind ourselves as to what took place with the Israelites in the books of Exodus, Leviticus, and Numbers. And we would understand what caused Moses to speak to the Israelites the way he did. It's not what, but who. God did. God gave Moses the message to the Israelites in Deuteronomy. God told Moses that he wanted the people to have hearts that were inclined to fear him. Genuine hearts that would respect, love, and obey him. What we must understand here is that there is a difference between doing something because it is required and doing something because we want to do it. Because we want to genuinely serve God. We want to genuinely obey God. And because of this, God knows we genuinely love him. Moses says, Hear, O Israel, the Lord is our God, the Lord alone. Moses is saying, Listen up, my people. While the nations around us may have had an abundance of gods, we, the people of Israel, know there is only one God, one true God. We are a people that wandered 40 years in a parched wilderness because of our stubbornness, because of our disobedience. He is saying, let's not make the same mistake which delayed our blessing. We could have been in the land of milk and honey many years ago, but our stubbornness caused our delay, caused us to suffer. Moses is saying, Hear, O Israel, listen, my people, take heed, don't repeat the same mistakes your ancestors made, but rather, let us embrace all what God is offering. Let us genuinely get it right this time. The Lord our God, the Lord is one. Verse 5 begins to state the statutes. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. Yes, we are to love God and think constantly of his commandments as these words come from God. It is a commandment from God through Moses. These words are commands, decrees, laws. The Lord God directed Moses to teach the people of Israel to observe in the land that they were crossing the Jordan to possess. They were crossing over, and he expected them to leave their old luggage behind and fully embrace the God of Israel. They were coming out of bondage into the land of land flowing with milk and honey, a land of prosperity, but it should not be taken lightly. God is telling the Israelites, there is a promise here. The promise is conditional. To truly possess the milk and honey, to truly possess the prosperity, you must live according to God's commandments. You must truly love God, for he is the God of Israel. Yes, God says, I am the God of your ancestors. I am the God that brought you through your darkness in the wilderness. I am the God that made this all possible for you. Friends, because of what God has done for these people, God is saying, these commandments should be easy for you to adhere to, easy for you to keep, easy for you to live by. Surely you don't want to bite the hand that fed you all those years. These commandments that I give you should be printed in your heart for easy access. But you see, God knew his people. He knew the Israelites. And because of this relationship, he sent his commands, his decrees and laws to the Israelites through Moses. And Moses delivered them. He told them to keep these commandments on your hearts, that they should be extended to their children. Yes, God said to impress them on your children in verse 7. Make sure you cover your family. God did not stop there. For Moses said God's commandments should be talked about when they sit at home, when they walk along the road, when they lie down, and when they get up. Take God with you wherever you go. Create a home life with God at the center. The word of God said they should tie their commandments as symbols on their hands and bind them on their foreheads and write them on their door frames, on their houses, and on their gates, lest they forget the God that brought them out of the wilderness. This passage of scripture begins with, Hear, O Israel. But it could have also begun with, If my people who are called by my name. Yes, brothers and sisters, God commands, decrees, and laws also apply to you and me today. The same love God wanted to receive from the Israelites is the same love God wants to receive from us. We are to love God and think constantly of him. Teach our children and live each day by the guidelines of his word. Parents, you are the head of your family. Not the teachers in the school, not the government. You are obligated to teach the Bible to your children and let them see God's love through you and the life you live. With all the turmoil in the world, we can see clearly that our children are under attack. If there's ever a time, it is now. We must cover our children, our household, with the Word of God. Teach our children to love the God of Israel, the God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, for He is the God of the whole earth. He is the waymaker, our provider, our protector, and He is the only true God. He has stood the test of time, and He still stands with open arms to forgive us of our sins and bring our family to know God, bring us into unity with God. Finally, brothers and sisters, these commands, these decrees and laws apply to our lives. Come with a promise. They come with a treat. Once we are a people, a family, an individual who adheres to God's words, it will be well with us. God promises to never leave us nor forsake us. And in closing, I recall the words of Paul in 2 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 20. For in him, every one of God's promises is a yes. For this reason, it is through him that we say the amen to the glory of God. Hear, O Israel, my people, if you need to fight for your family, love God with all your heart, with all your soul, and with all your strength, and watch God show up for you. God's mercy has never failed me yet. May God add understanding to His word. Amen. Our closing song is The Goodness of God.
Your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful. Oh, yeah.
Now receive the benediction. May the God of peace himself sanctify you completely, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless at the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. He who calls you is faithful. He will surely do it. Amen.